Lucas from Hollywood, Florida. You have given me the hardest mystery I can ever imagine. I can't solve it. Siri. Mystery detectives near me.
Here's what I found.
Clueless detectives, that doesn't sound very helpful. But they do have a 5-star rating and one review from Uncle Ben. Well, I'll give them a try.
Stop. It's my phone. Quiet down, okay? Let me put them on speakerphone. Thank you for calling the Clueless Detectives. If you have a mystery,
Case, baby.
Okay, this is Colonel Mustard. I was wondering if you guys could help me with a case.
You bet we can help you, Honey Mustard.
It's Colonel Mustard, not Honey Mustard.
Don't mind Uncle Ben.
Yeah, we ignore Uncle Ben all the time. You'll ignore this case. You're right, I will.
Hello, Colonel Mustard. Thank you for calling us. We would love to help. If you can, please email us the mystery and then head on over to our office.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. What's your email address?
Oh, sure. It's imaprincess@cluelessdetectives.com.
Wow, that's a surprise. Okay, sorry. Thank you for the mystery. We'll get on it as soon as we can. See you soon. Ciao!
Oh, guys, another new mystery. I'm so excited. Let me check. Oh, I got it.
Okay, perfect. All right. Here's the mystery. Marcus from Hollywood, Florida says, can you help me solve this mystery? It's from Matthew 13, 31 through 32. Jesus says, the kingdom of heaven is like a mustard seed planted in a field. It is the smallest of all seeds, but it becomes the largest of garden plants. It grows into a tree, and birds come and make nests in its branches. Wow, that is a tough mystery right there.
Wait, are you sure?
Is that the worst mystery I've ever
solved? Like, listen. You guys know I love mustard, right? Mm-hmm. I love mustard on, you know, my hot dogs. I love mustard on my hamburgers. I even love mustard on my corn dogs. But the best combination is honey mustard and donuts. That is the best combination I have ever had.
Ew! Uncle Ben, it's not even close to what this mystery is talking about. So far!
I'm gonna go get the door. Thank goodness Uncle Ben's grossing me out with all that mustard stuff. I don't want to talk about that.
You guys, the John Mustard's here.
Oh.
Hello.
Hello.
Well, first off, it's Colonel Mustard.
That's what I said, Honey Mustard.
Seriously, it's Colonel Mustard.
Listen, honey, relax. We're here to help you.
Uncle Ben.
Whatever you say, Uncle Ben.
Welcome, Colonel Mustard. We're so happy you're here. We were just going over the mystery, and we have to agree that this is a pretty tough case.
Yes, I admit it is a tough case. I've been working on it for weeks.
So here's what we're going to do. Can you tell us what you've figured out so far, and then we'll take it from there?
Yes. I've collected some samples, and I have this tiny mustard seed.
It's there.
And then I've also collected this picture of a mustard tree.
Okay, wait. You're telling me that this giant tree comes from that tiny seed?
Yeah, that little thing, because this big huge tree is amazing.
Exactly. I'm just wondering, how can this tiny seed and that giant tree have to do with the kingdom of heaven?
I got it.
How are they connected?
I found it. This mystery is like an apple I ate last year in the backyard, you know? You guys know I have dentures. I bit into the apple, bit into the seed, my teeth fell out. So I had to pick up my teeth, grab the seeds, throw them behind me. Then a couple months later, now I have 5 apple trees in my backyard. I have Granny Smith apple tree number 1, apple tree number two.
Have you got one?
Okay, Uncle Ben, stop. Enough of the apple tree talk, because apple seeds and apple trees, they don't have anything to do with this mystery.
Wait. I know it's going to sound crazy, but I think Uncle Ben is actually onto something. Okay, go with me. Go with me, okay?
Okay.
So he had the seeds. Doesn't like them, throws them over. Next thing he knows, there's large apple trees.
Right.
Okay? And the mystery, Jesus said the mustard seed is tiny and then becomes a large tree. Jesus' kingdom is just like that.
You're right, because Jesus has started out with 12 disciples. Now he has, like, thousands, maybe even millions of disciples.
That's right, and that's awesome, because Jesus' kingdom didn't just start in Jerusalem and stay there. His kingdom is now all over the world.
So good. Jesus wants us to know that great things grow from small beginnings. That describes Jesus' kingdom perfectly.
Great things start from small beginnings. That is a great lesson and the greatest answer for this mystery. Thank you guys for helping me with this mystery.
Oh, it's our pleasure.
I gotta go back to my office and tell Marcus about this.
You are so welcome, Colonel Mustard, and it was also very nice to meet you.
Yes.
You know, I don't like to brag, but you know, that's why they call me the senior detective around here. And by the way, you're welcome, Princess Mustard.
All right, Colonel Mustard, before you go, let's pray and thank Jesus for helping us solve this mystery. Let's pray. Dear Jesus, we thank you that you have taught us that great things grow from small beginnings. And Jesus, we thank you that we are a part of your kingdom, that though it started small, it is the greatest kingdom on this earth, and you have included us as part of it. So, Jesus, we give you all the praise and the glory, and it's in your name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.